Hi, let us understand how to install Docker as a part of Linux operating system. For the demo purpose, I am going to get a Linux EC2 instance from AWS Cloud. AWS provides free access for 12 months with various services. You can register an account with AWS and you can get free EC2 access for 12 months with micro instance. And you can try Docker installation in the same free tier EC2 machine. Let me get into my AWS account. After logging in, this is how the management console looks like. I'm going to access the EC2 service. This is how EC2 dashboard looks like. Here I can get into the instance menu where I can launch a new instance. It provides option with the AMI. We call that as Amazon Machine Images. There are few frequently used Amazon images available, as well as through marketplace, I can get whatever the image I want, I can get it from here. For the demo purpose, I am going to use Amazon Linux 2 AMI, which is based out of Red Hat. Let me select the AMI, and here I am going to select an EC2 instance of type T2 medium. If you go with T2 micro, you will be having 1 GB RAM and 1 vCPU. For better experience, I am going with T2 medium, where I will be having 4 GB RAM and 2 vCPUs. Let me move on to the next screen. Here I will leave all the values as default, and I am going to request for one instance. I'll leave the network values as default. Let me say add storage. I'm going to make the storage as 20 GB. I'll make sure delete on termination is enabled, so that whenever I am terminating this particular instance, automatically the volume will also get deleted. Volume is nothing but it's equivalent to a hard disk. Let me add a tag with the key name and value as DCA Docker demo. Let me configure the security group. Let me go ahead and create a security group, DCA Docker demo. And here I can configure what port should be open to what IP address. I'm going to use port 22 to log in to this particular instance using SSH client. I'm going to give access only to my IP address so that it is more safe and secure. Anyone from outside this particular IP address will not be in a position to access this particular instance. Let me go ahead and review. I'll review the details and say launch. It provides an option to create or reuse any existing key to log into the machine. Let me go ahead and create a new key. Let me name the key as DCA Docker demo. And it provides only this particular option to download. Once if you lose this key, you cannot log into this particular instance. So make sure you download the key and keep it in a safe and secure location, and then launch the instance. And AWS provides the key in the PEM format, where you can use it directly either in the Linux or in Mac operating system. In Windows, you have to convert it into a format PPK, which is applicable or which can be used within the Windows operating system. For that purpose, I'm going to use a tool called PuttyGen. You can download the tool PuttyGen from this specific location. You will be utilizing two tools, that is, one is PuTTY, which is SSH client, which will be used to log into this particular instance, and PuTTYGen, which will be used to convert the PEM file into a PPK file. Already I have downloaded the tool. Let me open the tool and load the key. The key will be in PEM file. Select the key. And once the key is loaded, I'm going to save the private key. And it'll ask for the option to save it without the passphrase. I'll say yes and save the key, and it'll get stored in PPK format. Now I should have the file in PPK format, and I can use it with the PuTTY tool to log into the instance. Let me check the status of the EC2 instance. It is up and running, and it should have a public DNS along with public IP address. Let me copy the DNS. And I'm going to use it with the PuTTY tool. Let me copy the DNS. Let me name this as DCA Docker demo. And within connection data, I'm going to provide the user ID as EC2 dash user, which is the default user ID to log into Amazon Linux. Every AMI provides a default user ID to log in. In this case, I am going to use EC2 user. Under SSH auth option, I am going to select the key. Here I will be selecting the PPK file that we converted using PuTTYGen. Say open. And under connection, I will be changing this particular value to 30 so that every 30 seconds, it will keep on sending a null packet and keep this particular session active. Let me change the appearance so that we will have a better experience working with the SSH terminal. Let me make the font a little bigger and save this session for future use, so that I don't need to enter this particular value every time while opening the SSH terminal. First time when I am logging in, it's going to verify the fingerprint. Let me say yes. And I'm into the EC2 instance, and I can install whatever the software I want as long as it is legal. In this particular instance, I'm going to install Docker and configure it so that automatically it gets started whenever I am restarting the machine. So in a quick summary, we had seen how to start an EC2 instance from Amazon Cloud and connect to the EC2 instance.